Fungustober.
Direct.
Hello, everyone. I'm Fungustober, and welcome to this month's Fungustober Direct. In this video, I'm going to talk about many things. Revamped appearances, channel news, ways you can support me, and the content that will be released later this month. Ready? Here we go. A new look for Fungustober? As you may have noticed, the banner of this YouTube channel changed, and a new intro featured at the beginning of this video. This is part of an effort I'm making to change up the look of the channel a bit. The new banner is meant to symbolize the variety of things I'm interested in, such as art, space, and programming. In addition to the YouTube page changes, I've also changed how I'm representing myself in videos. Long, long ago, there was another channel which I uploaded videos to, which are now, thankfully, lost to time. I often showed myself on camera because I wasn't that good at video editing. However, with the development of my skills, new and horrendous self-image issues, and the lack of good cameras with which to film myself, I never had any to begin with, it's just that I've now actually realized it, I've moved more towards representing myself with images, such as in the video on the space launch system I did recently, or just not talking at all, like with most of the videos on this channel. Starting with this video, I will have a new, specific appearance whenever I talk in a video. Oh, it hasn't changed yet, has it? Hold on a second, let me just... Ta-da! Cool, isn't it? Made it myself. Now that I have a physical form, I can do all sorts of things, like point at you, or look confused, or whisper, and a bunch more stuff. I am told that this makes me a PNG-tuber, which I think is a kind of root vegetable. Part of the advantages of this are that I can have my digital representation be a lot more expressive in videos, rather than just a static, unchanging image from which you have to derive emotion. Another advantage with this system is that it shouldn't be that hard to add new expressions, because all of the different parts are on separate layers. If you're confused why I look like this, I'll explain later. If you aren't confused by why I look like this, and you're heading to the comments to type something rude, just remember, you know where this comes from too. You share my curse. I've just embraced it. I hope you like the new appearance of both me and the channel. And if you don't, then I'd like to hear any feedback you have. Now, let's get to the rest of the direct. A video reaches an astonishing amount of views. Back in the spring of this year, I created an animation showing a Soyuz T rocket and spacecraft from launch pad to orbit for a college class. Not even a year later, it has reached 5,000 views, and almost definitely a significant amount more by the time I finish this, which is absolutely staggering. According to YouTube's audience analytics, people from all across the world have watched the video, so I think some greetings and thanks are in order. Namaste and Danyavad to my viewers in India. Zdravstvuyte and Balshoye Spasiba to my Russian viewers. Privyet and Dyakuyu to my viewers in Ukraine, and a Slava Ukraini to you all. Hallo and Terima kasih to my Indonesian viewers. Assalamu alaikum and Ramat to my viewers in Uzbekistan. Hola and gracias to my Mexican viewers. Kamusta and Salamat to my viewers in the Philippines. Hello, hello and Tusen tack to my Swedish viewers. And hi, I guess, to my viewers in the United States. Thank you as well.
Hi, editing Fungustober here. As it turns out, there are now more countries in the audience analytics, so that means I have more hellos and thank yous to give. Woo! All right, let's get to this. So, for my viewers from Brazil, hola and obrigada. To my viewers from Vietnam, xin chào and cảm ơn. To my viewers from Uruguay, bienvenidos and gracias. To my viewers from the UK, from the United Kingdom, hello and thank you. To my viewers from Guatemala, mucho gusto, and gracias. Alright. Getting back to all the rest of the stuff. Goodbye, hopefully. Hopefully this is the last time that editing Fungustober needs to interrupt the video.
Looking at more statistics of this video, a good portion of the people who watched it were people who have never seen my channel before. Which, I guess makes sense, since most of my videos have averaged around 30 views. Because of this, most of the people who watched the Soyuz T animation weren't subscribed, as only 0.7% of the watch time came from people who were. To celebrate all this, let's go pick apart my mistakes, by looking at every incorrect detail and animation error in the video. If you go to the very first frame of the video, you'll see where I forgot to remove a single frame of the flames. It's incredibly brief, which is probably why I didn't catch it until long after I had exported it. There's other subtle things, like the launch escape tower being off-center, and the boosters being badly proportioned. More noticeable, however, is the fact that the perspective of the rocket is all over the place. There's parts of it that have curved lines to suggest that this is a 3D shape, which are right next to entirely straight lines, which kill the illusion. And the Soyuz spacecraft that appears at the end is a different perspective from the upper stage it detaches from. I should have caught this, but I was more focused on getting it done at the time, and I didn't really want to put that much effort into a school project. I didn't anticipate the fact that it would somehow become the most viewed thing I've ever made, which I guess just goes to show you that you should always give it your all. If something's worth doing, it's worth putting your entire ass into it. Like with the solar panel opening sequence at the end of the animation. This was probably the most complicated bit of the animation. How I achieved this was by creating a bunch of separate layers, each of which made up one square on the solar panels. Then, for each of the sides of the spacecraft, the solar panel images were parented together. Then, I used the transform tools available to me to squash all the squares to make it appear as if they were on the side of the spacecraft. For some of the solar panel squares, I also made an alternate drawing for them that showed the back of the solar panels. They would switch between these two drawings when they reached a point where one side was no longer visible and the other side would come into view. Then, when the animation had the Soyuz detach from the upper stage, I essentially reversed the squashing process to return each square to as close to its original position as I could. Returning to things I did wrong, the side boosters fall away a little too fast in the animation, making their movements, say, little awkward. Instead of making them move down the instant they detached, I should have given them a little time to start rotating away from the rocket, then start moving down. This would have made the boosters no longer look like they were getting ripped off the rocket. One last mistake is that I got the order of staging slightly wrong. In the animation, I had the upper stage separate from the lower stage, then the payload shroud be jettisoned. In fact, it should be the other way around, as demonstrated in this video by the European Space Agency. Anyway, once again, Danyavad, Balshoya, Spasiba, Dyakuyu, Terimakasi, Ramat, Gracias, Salamat, Tusentak,
Obrigada, Kam On.
Thank you all for getting that video to 5,000 views. Here's to 5,000 more. Want to support me monetarily? Well, you can. Hey, did you know I have a Patreon page? Well, now you do. There's three tiers, silver, gold, and platinum, aka the $5 tier, the $10 tier, and the $20 tier. Silver tier lets you see early access content, like this video, which patrons got to see before anyone else, your name in the Patreon section of the video, and high-resolution content. Gold tier gets all that, as well as progress posts, so they get to know about things I haven't even announced. And the highest tier, the Platinum tier, gets all the previous benefits, plus downloadable content, plus their name read out loud in the Patreon section. This is where I'd read out the names of the Platinum tier patrons, if I actually had any. Patreon isn't the only way you can support me, though. I also have a Fiverr page, where you can pay me $25 to make a line art drawing, $35 for a color drawing with a solid background, and $50 for a color drawing with a complex background. If you want me to make art for you, then just head down into the description, where you'll find a link to a page with all the details. Make sure to contact me using the website's features before you buy, so I can help you the best I can. You could also support me by liking, commenting, and/or subscribing, which doesn't cost you anything at all. Your support is important to me because of circumstances. and also because it allows me to keep making videos well into the future without having to eventually submit to the whims of sponsors. This means that you won't have to hear me regurgitate talking points about, say, Surfshark, G Fuel, or that demon that all nature abhors, Raid Shadow Legends. Because, let's get real for a second, VPNs don't actually make you that much safer on the web. You don't need energy drinks to play video games or watch other people play video games, and Raid Shadow Legends is a pile of flaming shit. Okay, I've spent more than enough of your time asking for money. Let's get back to the rest of the direct. Let's take a look at the videos that will be released later this month. Another song by Fungustober releases soon, and this time it's a rearrangement of a classic. The 60th anniversary of the hit TV show Doctor Who has arrived. I've been a fan of Doctor Who ever since I was a little kid, and this year I decided to do something to celebrate it. Releasing on the 21st of December at 5 p.m. Central Standard Time is a video which features not only a reorchestration and rearrangement of the Doctor Who theme, but also some incidental music to boot. See you there! Get ready to retrieve your arms and hit that S. Homestuck, other than being the source of inspiration for this new form, is a multimedia web comic? Serial? Story? Something that first started releasing content in 2009 and ran until 2016. Over that period, it amassed a number of fans? No, that doesn't sound right. I think people who spend a significant amount of their time thinking about Homestuck works better. This group of people have made countless offerings to the dark god they call Andrew Ha-Si in an attempt to appease this chaotic entity. These offerings include creations of the visual medium, such as comics and internet memes. Alas, Homestuck doesn't just feature sights, but sounds as well, and the offerings didn't work. The wrath of Andrew Ha-Si is said to stain the land even now. Me? You want me to do something about it? Fine, I've got to do everything myself. Hold on. Yes, your auditory organs, whatever they may be, do not deceive you. On December 18th at 8 p.m. Central Standard Time, I will be releasing a video in which I read various internet posts as Homestuck characters. Tumblr user Gigas is a Biscuit is the one who originally found these posts and turned them into tweets for some reason. I carried out the laborious task of downloading the ones I thought were funny. Oh, and doing voices for them and editing all the voice clips together, I guess. Here's the first post that shows up in the video.
Back by unpopular demand.
Don't get too excited. That's all you get for now. Bye. And that's every upcoming release, except for a video that I will be releasing on the 30th that talks about some of the issues I encountered in trying to get this all together. Thank you all for watching this month's Fungustober Direct. There will not be a Direct during January 2024, and potentially not during February either, as making this took a lot of time and I want to take a bit of a break. This also gives me more time to work on future projects. Goodbye, everyone. Thank you for your time.